many Iranian Jews who hope the mildly reformist regime of former President Mohammad Khatami would bring the changes they feel Iran so badly needs. Much of the youth today wants Iran to modernize, become more democratic, allow them rights to demonstrate, for instance, and guarantee journalists and writers freedom of speech. Now, in the late 1990s, they thought those goals were within reach. But despite the so-called reformist regime, real reform never came. An elected conservative government led by President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad soon dashed all hopes of moving Iranian politics away from clerical domination. But the desire for reform still burns among many Iranian youth. And here now is a look at their story.
In July 1999, a group of students held a protest outside the University of Tehran. They were campaigning against the closure of an Iranian newspaper that supported some of the reformist ideas. Within a few days, the movement had spread across the country. The world heard the voice of a generation which emerged from the Iranian Revolution, and the West caught a glimpse of a hope the Islamic regime might fall. But the religious wouldn't compromise, and a bloody repression took hold. Today, it's the highly controversial President Ahmadinejad who's replaced the reformists. But what happened to the questioning behind the 1999 protests? And how did the young people get on living alongside the religious conservatives? Tehran and its 12 million inhabitants. In this city, it's not unusual to find religious monuments and traditional bazaars in fashionable neighborhoods by trendy shops. In the streets, the contrast between different social groups couldn't be more obvious. Islamic clergy and women cloaked in black walk next to young people wearing modern clothes and makeup, designed to make Iranian women look more Western. Hannah's 22 years old, but she doesn't really look it. At first sight, the scientific analyzer specializing in hydrocarbons could be mistaken for a bit of a hippie. She finishes work at 5 o'clock every evening and meets friends in a cafe in Tehran, where they drink tea and soft drinks. Alcohol is strictly forbidden in the Islamic Republic of Iran. There's not much for young people to do. They usually meet up to discuss everyday things, arts and politics. But today, Hannah wants to talk about something more serious. Last year, one of her friends was arrested for taking part in a protest. She's just found out what sentence she'll receive.
Interested in, so they're useful for society.
2 meters of material aren't going to stop someone from doing what they want.
Doğumet parça dolaşım endüstrisi.
That's the very nature of the Islamic constitution. Personally, I'd have preferred it not to have been mentioned in legal text. In Iran, wearing the Islamic veil has been compulsory since the revolution in 1979, but a lot's changed since then. These days, the veil isn't worn so strictly. Sometimes women wear it as a scarf, others use it as a fashion accessory. In Tehran's northern neighborhoods, young fashionable Iranians are increasingly pushing the Islamic law to the limit, standing up to the authorities over dress law clampdowns. Hannah's home reflects upper-class Iranian lifestyle. Her family's happy to welcome foreign friends over a cup of tea, like Golnaz, who left Iran with her family when she was 15 years old. Now, she has American citizenship, and despite loving the country where she was born, her views about Iran are clear.
There's no opportunity to grow here, because, you know, there's no job, and the government is so strict, and it doesn't let you do anything, so...
Hannah's parents agree. Young people don't have any freedom. Universities accept a limited number of students. Youngsters here are unemployed. They want to go to university, but they can't get in. It's really hard for them.
The future is uncertain for those who go to university and find work. Like my daughter, who graduated this year. It's very difficult to find a job. Luckily, my daughter succeeded, thanks to her sister, who introduced her to her own bosses. That's how she was able to find work.
In Iran, the gross domestic product per person is less than 200 euros a month. That's despite the Islamic Republic being the world's fourth biggest petrol producer. President Ahmadinejad came into power in 2005, thanks to the economic promises he made. Since then, the economy's been in freefall and people have less personal freedom. They talk about the past with nostalgia.
One of the most loveliest experiences during Khatami was the press, and the bookshops were full of interesting and fabulous books. But now we don't.
Having access to culture and information is a must for young people. But in Iran, internet connections are made slower to reduce access to multimedia sites.
Why isn't it downloading? Be patient, you're in Iran. The connection is very slow.
10 million sites are inaccessible because the Iranian authorities believe they don't conform with Islamic teaching. Many people see the censorship as an injustice.
After a while, the system that censored the access to the internet gotta give up. The virtual world is going to be a main part of the people's life. So it'll be waiting.
Hannah isn't waiting to be given authorization before she makes the move towards modernity. Back to Tahira, who is now in her university library. She was also eager to discuss the censorship.
Certain books written by Iranian political journalists are very interesting, but they're not always given the go-ahead for publication.
Have you tried to get hold of them?
Yes, sometimes I've got them from certain booksellers not far from the university, or I borrow them from someone who has managed to find a copy. Up until now, I've pretty much managed to get my hands on the books I want to read.
Iranians have become specialists in finding ways of getting around the system. DVD sales take place hidden under coats, satellite dishes are supplied on building roofs, and flirting takes place in cars at night. The waft of rebellion hovers over Iran like a discreet perfume. Like here, in this grunge cafe, decorated by college students.